Have you ever added a bunch of adjustment layers to your photo and found that you've got more photos that are similar that you'd like to just drag and drop that set of adjustment layers to, found that you can't and you can't even copy and paste them over? Today I'm going to show you how to save that set of adjustment layers as a color lookup table or a LUT and how to apply those to your other photos. This is the same method that you can use to create custom LUTs for your video. All you have to do is take a snapshot of your video, open that photo up in Photoshop, and use the same methods that I'm about to teach you here. All right, so as you can see, I've got this photo that I've added a bunch of adjustments to, but I've got more photos that I'd like to add those exact same adjustments to. Make sure that every adjustment that you want in your lookup table to be selected. Then go to File, Export, and Color Lookup Table. I tend to save mine as .cube files only because that's the only format that I really need for photo and for video. I usually rename and save these in the exact same file that I'm currently working in. Save. Just find it in the file that you're working in. There it is. But what I do suggest you do is that you actually take this into the main LUTs folder. And if you don't know where it is, you can just search for it. Go to your File Explorer or your Finder in a Mac and search for 3D LUTs. And there's the folder you'll find it in your Photoshop program files. Just open that up and you'll see that you've got your pre-existing LUTs. And just drag and drop that over. Continue. Now go to your photo that you'd like to apply this LUT to. Go to Window, Adjustments, and click on this icon that looks like a grid that says Create a New Color Lookup Adjustment Layer. And there you'll find the option to load your 3D LUT. Now, because we haven't restarted Photoshop yet, your new LUT won't be available as an option in your 3D LUTs folder. But just click up here and go to the file and go into the current folder that you saved it in originally. Load. And there it is. That's how I ensure that all the photos within my GIF were consistent. If you're at all interested in learning how to make a GIF, I'll link that video in the description below. And as per usual, thanks so much for watching.